Hey guys, I'm Sonia from Nave. Our product helps you achieve faster, better, and more predictable service delivery by optimizing your workflow efficiency. There are three basic flow metrics we focus on. Cycle time, which measures the time between starting and finishing work on a given task. Throughput, which is the number of tasks delivered on a certain day, week, or month. And work in progress, or the amount of tasks available in each process state. Our goal is to help you limit work in progress, reduce cycle times, and increase throughput. So, how do you know how much is in progress and how much is actually being done? The Cumulative Flow Diagram provides an overview of the current state of your process by tracking the total number of tasks in progress each day. The vertical axis shows the number of tasks, while the horizontal axis plots your timeline. The graph is built from colored bands, with each band indicating how many tasks are present in each process state. In order to achieve an efficient workflow, you need to apply a work in progress limit. You can start with a limit around the number of your team members and adjust it later on. The size of the areas in CFD indicates how many tasks are currently in your process for the selected date. You can also see the number of tasks in progress in each process state, as well as the accumulated number of tasks completed, those in the done state, in the selected time frame. Watch out for a flatter gradient in your done data. The slower it grows, the longer your delivery times. Always strive to keep the work in progress within the limit. This is the key to achieving a stable process. You can monitor how work in progress trends build over time using the advanced work in progress chart overlay. It shows the number of tasks in progress for each day in the selected time frame. Ideally, the line should stay even or go down. If the line goes up, this means work in progress goes up and your team is working on more tasks than they are able to handle. Increased work in progress usually results in increased cycle times, reduced team efficiency, and potential project delays. The Cumulative Flow Diagram enables you to spot bottlenecks instantly. If one or more of the areas that represent work in progress start expanding, then it signifies a bottleneck in that state. You can zoom into a certain section for a more precise overview. Remember to account for any changes like team size or public holidays before jumping to conclusions. These could provide explanations for unexpected spikes in activity. The horizontal distance between the top and the bottom line of a CFD area at any point along the graph is your process approximate average cycle time. Approximate average cycle time shows how long it took on average for items to complete on the selected date. You can also assess the approximate average cycle time for items that finished between two workflow steps. The Cumulative Flow Diagram enables you to evaluate the efficiency of your workflow and help you identify problem areas in order to achieve a stable and healthy process. In a stable system, the average arrival rate is roughly equal to the average throughput. This means that the tasks arrive in the process at the same speed as they leave it, and you have managed to balance demand versus throughput. You can evaluate your process health using the Advanced Process Metric overlay for the whole process and per process state. Based on Little's law, average cycle time equals average work in progress divided by average throughput. The more accurate the equation, the healthier your process. If the math breaks down for you, it is time to take a closer look at your workflow. It is important to say that the data displayed on the CFD depicts only what has happened for a given process and it shouldn't be used for any type of estimations. Join me in the next video to explore how to use cycle time scatterplots to optimize the efficiency of your workflow.